Hi, welcome to this Varasi video. Today's conversation is on managing multiple Salesforce orgs following a merger or an acquisition. The context for today's conversation is the following. As part of your corporate strategy, you're constantly looking to improve the portfolio of products and services that you have. You're looking to expand into new markets. You're looking to add new revenue streams. Now, each of these could be drivers for the acquisitions that you end up making. Now, with each acquisition, you inherit a new CRM system and a new CRM team. These could be, say, in the form of new call centers that you have inherited, or new digital marketing efforts that now need to be aligned and made consistent with your parent organization, or common customers that you were both selling into that you now need to rationalize. And chances are that you have found yourself another Salesforce org that you have now inherited. An org in Salesforce speak, very simply put, is the specific instance or version of a customer Salesforce system. So let's go over some considerations and some options that you now have available as you make a decision on the fate of the two orgs that you have. So what are some considerations that go into your decision? First, there's the broad theme of compliance and legal drivers. As in, depending on the industry that you operate in, there could be restrictions on the amount of collaboration or the sharing of data that is allowed for the two operations. And that restricts your options available for a path forward. Chances, though, are that the flip side is more true, which is that there is now a need for consolidation of reporting. The second big theme is the need to streamline data and processes. The acquired company may have been selling into the common customers that you also sell into, and going forward, you need to have a unified view of the customer across both these operations. The acquired company may have its own processes for managing leads and managing sales deals and how to report on pipeline. And this is the point in time, purely from a standpoint of efficiencies, to rationalize and decide on a single path going forward. There's likely some duplicate functionality between the two orgs and some redundant efforts that this is a good point in time to rationalize and decide again on a path going forward. Similarly, this is also a point in time when you can assess some best practices that are coming in from the acquired org and make it part of the parent org as well and make it company-wide. The final set of considerations have to do with the governance of the Salesforce orgs. Do you have users that you need to track now as licensed users across multiple orgs? Do you have AppExchange apps and apps that you may have built that you now need to track across multiple orgs? Do you have a central authority when it comes to keeping an eye on your technology investments, when it comes to streamlining your interactions with vendors and partners, when it comes to the development resources and the maintenance resources that you're allocating to Salesforce projects in your company? Now, if you don't have a center of excellence in place, this is also a good time to trigger that conversation and think hard about it. With all that said, you will arrive at one of two strategies going forward. Either continue to maintain multiple orgs or have a one consolidated single org. The first strategy, because you have either chosen to continue operations as silos and run the two operations separately, or because you have rationalized the products and services and you have now differentiated your orgs based on the industries that you sell into, or say the geographies that you sell into, or the or your own product lines. On the other hand, you may have one consolidated single org because you have chosen to use one of the two orgs, either the parent or the acquired company's org as the master, and you have folded the other org into it. Or you have chosen to architect a brand new org altogether, and you have picked best practices from each of the two orgs, and you have folded them into the brand new org. Hope that discussion was useful to you. I look forward to seeing you in more Varasi videos. Thank you for watching.